All right, welcome back to Face It TV. Ladies and gents, here for the John Wick Invitational. And I really need to see this movie, man. I can't take it, seeing this trailer over and over again. But guys, we apologize for the delays. We had some issues with the servers going on, and that really just threw a wrench into the works. But we are going to be moving on to the stream team, TST versus Denial, and that's going to be a pretty interesting match. Obviously, a lot of famous characters, some infamous characters on the stream team, and we do have Denial playing them. And actually, they previously played very recently, in fact, in a best of one for the DreamHack Winter Qualifier, in which Denial actually won. So it was close, 16-14, as close as you can really have it, bar and overtime. So these teams are definitely looking to be quite a good match for one another.
Indeed. The other match has just resumed, so we'll keep you informed as to what's happening there during this match. But we are due to start this match. For scheduling reasons, we will be going on to the second match here. So we are due to be flipping into the match very shortly, and as if by magic.
Knives.
Here we go.
They're going to be knifing in the streets. These aren't really very well looked after streets, though, I've got to say. There's like sand everywhere. Well, I suppose that's why they call it dust, isn't it? And looks like there's been a... These two guys don't want to play by the rules of everybody else going to decide. We're not going to conform. We're going to knife in mid whilst you guys knife in long. And will it be Statutory Ape or Damps the Windows Door? I don't know. There you go. I actually... Wait, I just remembered that I have kind of a policy that I don't cast knife rounds. Play by play, at least. So I'm gonna return to that. I think that was put in place for a reason.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing the stream team. Haven't seen them playing a match before, and I know a bunch of them will be streaming these matches as well. Adrenaline X, I Buy Power. Let's see what his name is here. Adrenaline, in fact, and Anger, obviously. You'll be familiar with him as well.
The Volcano, the Mapper, the guy who makes them maps that we all love and play. He made cash, so I'm in love with him. Gonna throw that out there. I'm a little volcano.
Congratulations.
He gave us
cash.
I
hope you also keep it the same way.
The marriage is gonna happen soon. He doesn't know it yet. I haven't mentioned any of this to him. I don't think I've even ever spoken to him before, but it's fine. I'm sure he'll be happy.
You're just getting mad, getting your stalker on.
Hey man, it's gonna be a budding romance. You'll see. Anyways, actually thinking about it, with Adren on the server, I think it's pretty hard if you're looking for any kind of CSGO videos on YouTube not to see an Adren video, basically. If you somehow manage that, then you're doing something very crazy to actually have that happen. Lots of videos there and tips and tricks that can be found on YouTube. Adren contributing to the community quite significantly. And Denali is a team that we've seen quite a bit of recently. They have some great players. I think we've seen brilliant stuff from pretty much all of them, notably Shazam. I don't know why I had a weird inflection going on there. It happens sometimes.
I have to mention that Nitro is their newest member. They took him in instead of Juvenile, who used to be their fifth, but Nitro is joining them from Area 51.
Yes, and we are due to go into the game very shortly. So we are going to be jumping live very soon, and I pretty much can't wait. We already saw a nice Dust 2 game between Area 51 and Savage, which I'm quite surprised how well Area 51 bounced back into that one. It was madness, anti-ecos not quite going the way that either team would expect, repeatedly. And that's something we saw, I think, in previous matches that we cast on Dust 2 in America. I've got to say, Dust 2 matches from the American teams are just the best. I've seen some awesome Dust 2 games between the American teams.
Let's see if this will be another one. Some fishing going on from both teams through the double doors at the moment. With some spray and spam going on. Not much damage on either side here, as T's will go towards the short area. So they're going to go for a full stack, make themselves as big a target as possible here. Lots of firepower from the T's.
And there's nobody actually on the site. There's nobody even on slope, in fact. The majority are congregating around CT spawn and now making their way up through middle. We're going to see the battle up through onto short now as Shazam's going to make his way in. He's got Nitro there to help him, but they are gunning down the defense. It is falling all too easily as pretty much everybody falls within the matter of seconds of one another. And that's a very easy retake for Denon. And obviously, we could see that they were playing for that. They've stacked loads of players kind of together, and they gave up position on A immediately and decided, all right, let's our strategy here will be for a retake. And it worked out very well for them. So very nice there. Actually, got to say, that's not something I've seen all that often. And definitely good to see things like that to keep it fresh. But it is going to be the stream team who are going to be ecoing now.
Indeed. So we may see a full B rush here from the stream team. They did get their bomb down, which means that they'll be able to buy AKs in the next round based on the buy in this round. We are going to have Daps going aggressive here with the MP7, but they need to be careful because they have got these 50s. Just get 3 kills there, but that's going to be worth it for him. But can they get their bomb down? Again, this would be fantastic for them if they can make it there fast enough. Shazam's quite close up, so double stack plant is going to be real. Volcano not getting it down in time. Sakitori 8 manages to get down Shazam, but that's not going to give him enough time to get the bomb down. We should expect the buyer to come out here, though.
So much money for Daps there. Oh my god, that the MP7. I actually love it when people actually connect with that weapon. It's brilliant. It reminds me of the old days with the MP5 bunny hopping around in like 1.3. Those were the days. I got really mad when they patched out the ability to jump in succession without losing speed. I got really angry when that happened. I think it was 1.5 when that happened, if I'm not mistaken. But I was really sad. Either way, 2-0. As we are seeing the buy coming in from TST. And they did get the bomb down in the first round, and that's obviously why they're able to only have to eco once and can now follow up with the AKs. And of course, having a bit of a trouble getting onto some position at the moment. We do have the standard setups coming in. Shazam actually moving forward to the scene. They're getting close now to short. And this very well be the location that TST find themselves with a pick in, as Shazam, surely he can't do much with the CZ, but he might just catch them not looking. That's Adren going down quite low, down to 15 health after that little tag from Shazam. So good work done by him. He does finally get dealt with as they decide to push that area a little bit. Nitro ready to find some heads. Shazam 8 with a very timely dodge, going to keep himself alive. Make him enter the site. Oh my goodness, that bullet curved around the edge there. Bending through space on time, but it's going to be Daps and Fugly in the back to make the frags happen. Drop the bomb down into middle. Pex has to hold on though, else things are going to get very grim indeed.
Fugly going to be the last man standing here for the CTs. Versus 3, he could still do this though with Adren and Pex on less than 30 HP combined. He's going to chase him down short. He's going to have someone waiting for him. It's going to be Adrenaline just on the A slope. It's going to think it's 10 HP, so really unfortunate there. Did have potential to do some damage in that round. Unfortunately, he did get caught short by the T's.
So the pause coming in, but things kind of progressing as one would expect currently. TST able to win their first buy round and reapply that pressure. And it's a bit of an awkward money situation for Denali. They have Shazam with 6k. Obviously, he was ready to get that AWP, only buying the CZ in the previous round. So he really wants to buy that AWP. But what do you think? Are they in a position where an AWP is a sensible option, or do you think the save is more worthwhile with Shazam just buying some pistols?
Sorry, could you repeat that?
I was going to say, should they buy pistols? I was thinking that they should. I mean, you don't really want to buy an AWP if you can't get any support, do you?
Oh, no, I don't think it's worth doing. And it seems Angle's getting some DDoS, but that is the fastest switch I have ever seen into another connection. So
this guy's prepared, well, man.
Well played to him. That guy is all over this.
I'm going to high-five him.
We have a four-man push here. Down long from Denial with the pistols, but there's only going to be one person there to meet them, and there is a smoke, which means both sides. Volcano just going to hold the angle on the edge of the smoke there in case there's a push from the CTs.
And no one to reveal themselves just yet, as Shazam is close to the double doors and anxious to get a peek in and a quick frag. We've already seen him do quite a bit of damage with that CZ. The smoke's off though, very timely smoke. Volcano playing with fire now. Keep coming in from Fugly. Easily discarded there by Volcano, as is his friend Nitro. Now Wong is in control of the terrorist side. The stream team able to go a bunch of players ahead. Now just two. And two pistols to deal with. And largely, oh my goodness, I was was a very lovely connection there, finding the head of anger. But the retrade does come in. And I doubt too much damage can really be accomplished. Just to be 2,000 left at Daps, unless he can find the CZ. There it is. The future is now. Shazam CZ picked up, as he's going to try to do some extra damage. Any other damage, actually, already two players found. If he does get a third one, that would be beautiful. He'll definitely be happy with that. And they are going to be buying in the following round. So, yes, so Shazam will be able to purchase that AWP. We're going to see the full buy from Denial. And it's going to be interesting to see how their setup, you know, really works.
Indeed, that's the last man standing here. Does get picked. Won't manage to get any extra additional damage in. And we should see the guns coming out for Denial here. Going to try and get themselves back into the game. Shazam going for the AWP with no head armor. But the AKs from the terrorist team won't really matter that much. If at all.
Oh my goodness.
Ooh, Nitro with the Org.
Yeah, man. The Org. Respect for the Org. And you don't ever see it now. I don't think I've seen an Org in ages. And I've casted a lot of CS. Probably casted more CS than anybody else in the last few weeks. That's for sure. And I haven't seen an Org in ages.
Straight on Volcano's toes. It's going to ruin his pedicure.
Maybe he's just Orging because that skin is totally badass. That could be the reason.
He's playing pretty close up. Well, he was playing pretty close up on Long, but he has gone back to the pit. So curious to see what the meaning of this Org purchase is. In the meantime, we are going to see the terrorist team. They're just going to hold some angles for the time being, try and find an overextending T and then make a play on that. We do have the double stack here. This is interesting. I don't think... Have you seen that before?
Yes.
That was pretty nice, actually.
It's quite rare. It's been a while since I've seen that, but it's been popping up here and there. Ready to make their way into the site. Already Shazam to whiff a shot. That's not a good start for the defense here for Denial, as we will have the grenades flurrying in onto the site. There's Shazam. He's going to find himself dropped before he can do anything, and we may have to put all of our hope into the Org if Denial are to make this round of work. Daps going to take a crack from the back onto Pex as he does go down, and the Org is not going to find any love just yet, as we will have Naf trying to bust his way through onto Short to punch a hole into that defense. It's going to be the pick there onto Volcano, the entry rather, as Adren tries to lock it down. That's a great shot onto Daps. Naf might just finish him off though, and now we're on a one-on-one, but the bomb is so far ticked. Naf has to instantly remove Statutory 8 from the map, but that's not going to be the case, as it will be a round for the terrorists. The stream team able to put themselves up a round against Denial.
Okay, so it's 3-2 in favor of TSC, as DDK just mentioned. It's going to be the CTs back on the eco once again. Full P250s here for the Denial team. Again, they're going to want to play these close quarters ranges with these P250s where it will allow them to get one-shot death on the terrorists here. All the terrorists with these helmets again, so that'll make the range all that more important. You can see there's a three-man huddle here going up Short, and Pex just spotting the information on Short. That range will be to his advantage there, and Trillin needs to be careful now, as he does get taken out, and that's going to be an AWP in the hands of Denial. Now they could get some real damage in. They are all still alive.
Some great AK work there from Volcano. The AWPer is still alive and kicking, though. Shazam goes in for the frag, gets the finish onto Volcano, and it's complete chaos in this match so far for Denial, who surely should have done a lot better than this, getting surprised by the push of Denial. Despite getting some early information, Denial just hitting the shots. And Anger going to try to remedy the situation very fast indeed by pushing his way up into the A site area, but it does get taken down by Fugly. As that bomb is down, and Daps is going to execute Statutory Ape as the round will be taken by Denial. And they even keep three weapons alive there, so that is a big deal on the CET side. Denial are going to be pushing in hard now with a very strong loadout compared to what their opponents have to offer.
Two AKs in the hands of Denial here, which is going to be great for them. Now we find TST on the eco, and we've got a boost coming in from both teams now. Now we have a massive boost here into the Short area, so we may see a collision of guns here shortly. as Shazam is holding an angle, and you'll know that the player boosting him will be covering his back towards short, but they don't make the connection there, and it's going to be a four-man push through the smoke. They're all going to survive for now, see if they can get the bomb down.
And they are crushing this push onto the B site. Very easy hold there, just gunning away, using those smokes very effectively. And Denial is starting to build that bank, sending all that cash monies away to the savings as they're able to slowly get an advantage here. The buy will come in from the stream team, but it is going to be a bit of a scrappy one, not really finding the utility perhaps that they would have liked to find, seeing as they are lacking a distinct amount of funds right now. So far, a bit of a standard opening up to this round. We get to see really the smoke there on the Xbox or middle. And Shazam all ready to find a kill here. Oh, he's going to connect it onto Volcano. Good job there with the orb. Going back away now. That's suddenly going to make things a little bit more difficult. Already taking an early man advantage in this one.
Well, the flash is coming in from Anger over the smoke on short. Just going to try and push the CTs back should there be any CTs there. CTs are playing on the site at the moment with the exception of one throw along. The T's have pushed through mid. Looks like it's going to be a wrap around towards the B site while Anger's looking for the flanks, but Anger will get taken out by Fugly. Bomb is down as well, so T's need to move fast here. Going
Daps
in one by
beasting.
One.
Absolute beast of a man. That makes no sense, but he's getting lots of frags. He's finally going to get eliminated. Adren with actually two quick frags, in fact. More players for the challenge, but there's the third headshot found by Adren as he is absolutely destroying the opposition. Shazam on the boost there. On the crate, going to drop his way back off of there, lest he be found by Adrenaline's AK-47 as he makes his way back into the side, trying to find the frag onto Naf, but he didn't know exactly where he was, and Naf is going to be able to take him down. Beautiful, shot there onto a couple of those players. We are going to see ourselves 5-3, Denial. Two rounds ahead now, and things looking better and better for them, despite the explosion from Adren in that round. They're going to put that down to just an anomaly as they make their way forwards now against the Nitro. So tank there onto Nitro, but Sam to help him out. Sam pulling out the pistol momentarily. In comes the orb. Let's connect the shot. There's two more players to find help. Going to actually make it happen with the hip shot. Denial with a clean round, more or less. Just Nitro going down. But now the buy to worry about from TST.
Indeed, Shazam, the AWPA for the CT side has $12,500 in the bank right now. So Denial going huge in these previous rounds. Look at the money on the T side. None of them have got over $1,000. It's looking a bit disastrous for TST at the moment, again, because of their economy. This will be a key round for them. They need to win. They need to win for it with as much people surviving as possible. Shazam playing the car position on long at the moment. Goes for the shot, doesn't make it. Peck's going to rip his head off, and it's going to be a 4-3 in favor of the Denial CT team.
The bomber's kind of actually stuck at top mid, despite Peck's finding himself on the site of graffiti at the moment, so it's kind of strange. Positionally, what do they do with this? Well, it looks like Adren is going to find himself a pick onto Naf. Adren is certainly showing us quite the skills right now. They're going to make their way onto the A site now, finally combining with Pex, who's had this graffiti position for ages. I'm going to gun him down. The headshot found by Fugly as in comes Nitro, looking for the spray. Does find the first kill onto Anger, has to get the angle. Adren whiffs the shot, won't get the chance for another one. And that's going to be another round there for Denial as they make their way to a steady advantage of four rounds now.
Denial definitely starting to clean things up here, the street sweepers. We may see the buy here from TST, but it looks like no, it's going to be the very late buy, but they are in fact going to do it, which doesn't make complete sense as they can almost all get the AK. Some nades in for Adren, and let's see what these people do. We have aggressive long play, just the doors being held here by the T's. It's going to be a Volcano in that area, while we have a three-man push through B tunnel into mid. Looks like they're going to peek up short again. We have two CTs on the D slope here. One of them is going to be Fugly, joined by his teammate Daps. So they're going to have a strong presence in mid. We started off this round just in case there's a push from mid, but it looks like we may see some peeking in the short area. We have some nades and counter nades coming in from both teams, but no big damage done just yet.
Yeah, just patiently awaiting something to break for someone to get impatient, but it's going to have to be TSC to make the move to bail out that reaction. Shazam's ready with the AWP for any short shenanigans, and there are soon to be some short shenanigans as they are gearing up for this. They do have the point man at the moment to be Anger, because he's ready, but Shazam also ready for this. Goes for the shot, able to make the tag, but not the frag. In goes the second shot, nothing more found. There, finally, Shazam coming in, and that's a good shot made. Decent defense held, and we are going to see a lackluster push up short, and then you have to rely on creating other opportunities, and there they find them. Two individual picks there, as we do have Volcano up on Volcano on long and Pex on short. Pex going to get caught on the side by Naf, as it all relies now on this man, Volcano. And he managed to make his way onto the save. There's two players left and gets caught in the brain by Wallbanger Fugly from that M4. And that is certainly going to be a very happy denial. Their bank is like almost not touched at this point. They are going to spend some extra cash there, but that's just so healthy, isn't it? 8-3 the score. As once again, TST just in the AKs and no nades.
Okay, you've got the force bite again coming out here for the terrorist side. And Daps is going to... You know, he's trying to photobomb there, and he will and pay for it as he will leave the building. That is a disastrous start here for the CTs. Nathlite on 1 HP, Sam on 8 HP. This is going really bad here for Denial. They are 5 rounds up. All the frags coming in for the T's now. Only 2 Denial players remaining, Fugly and Nitro. Adrenaline going to look away at the wrong time, and the new man Nitro will take him out. Volcano up against 2 now. Trade frag. Flank coming in there, and the CTs have brought this back to 2v1.
There's this Anger left alive. He is going to feel compelled to push through. The bomb is just stuck on that site. There's not really much else he can try to accomplish in this round. Here he goes, going to go for it. Does get the quick headshot. That's beautiful, but it's going to be Fugly. He's going to get the trade, and it was an impossible situation. And yeah, it's quite surprising considering that Shazam decided... I mean, this guy is this traitorous guy with the scumbag move, whether he realized it or not. Teammate jumping through in very poor timing. Shazam now going to go for another peek onto middle, and not having an AWP themselves. TST kind of voiding middle completely until now. They do smoke it off. But Shazam is pretty close to the door still. Going to have to fall back. He does get compromised his position by the CT's movement. Nice,
make
his way to short.
Gonna throw that counter flash in case they were trying to push short there, just to slow them down a little bit more, and they may have recognized that there are additional people on A, and it looks like they might go for a mid push, possibly flashing themselves in. Still have control of B tunnels and the T side of long as well. However, we are seeing a rotation here from Peck to join his teammates, and it's coming through to push into B.
Anger out the window, down onto the site, but his teammates are largely lost in the process. Adren now coming in. He is going to see himself trouble. And trouble is going to put an end to him. 10-3. And Denial are not looking back. See 40 headshots so far on the counter. Being racked up, and one of those was Shazam's very nice team frag. Very nice team frag indeed. We should have a team frag highlight reel.
Indeed we should, but right now TST need to get some team frags together on the other team. And that's the second time Shazam's missed that shot, which is unlike him actually. He's shown some good consistency really, but not paying off those aggressive short peaks at the moment. Just trying to potentially move out of the way before taking a shot, which is sending his bullets to the wrong places. Gonna see a push here from Long, but they are gonna retreat after not getting a quick frag.
Yeah, actually, interesting how far they got up Long there, and look at the health of everyone on this stream team. Everybody is bleeding out at this point. Where's the medic, man? They could really use a medic. Or somebody with some kind of just a band-aid or something. Shazam going to find the shot onto Volcano. And we're going to see them make the last-ditch attempt onto that bombsite A. As Yeah, they make their way in. They get smoked off, though, so perhaps it'll just dissipate in time, so... All right. Let's be on the guy who's furthest away from the action. Thanks, ProDB. In goes Statutory Ape, though, with the Gillil. Gonna sneak his way over the barrel into Graffiti with the bomb in hand. Gonna drop that one on the side. That's a great result, because all things considered, getting the bomb down. Although, that said, there's only a couple rounds left in this one. He's sliding their way in, executing players as they find them. Now, Statutory Ape in a 1-on-2. And, Nath with a significant amount of health. Dap's going to tap his head away. And we're going to see another round there for Denial. As they go 11-3. It's looking good for them so far. And generally speaking, they're kind of out-executing. And they're really getting the damage in before the push finds its way to a site. And that's like thinning them out like that seems to really be causing all the problems for the stream team's aggressions. Because they've been looking good otherwise.
Indeed, this is the last round of the first half here. TST with only 3 rounds of a possible 14. This is not going well for them whatsoever. They're going to have to go massive if they are to bring things back here on the second half. You can see some presence here from TST in the middle area with just, again, it's going to be Volcano just loitering around the long area. Not going to breach on his own, but he may find Nitro looking for him shortly. Shazam is going to take off Anger's head on the short area. That may slow down the terrorists going forward.
Tried to push out middle though as the distraction was run towards A, and that's kept the players on the site. Adren looking for the drop. There it is. Hits the flick. Shazam hits the ground cold as we now have TST making their way back after the pick, feeling happy with themselves. Gonna go for the quick rotate. And all too long, actually, it looks like. Or is it? Yeah, it looks like it's gonna be long. They've left one player in. It is Adren with that AWP to try to cut off the rotating players as the rest of his team is going to occupy long. And I think Denial are going to work this out relatively soon, especially now that they've seen 3 players towards that angle. Shazam going to really be down as Adren was able to cut off one player before he finally does get sent to the bench. And it looks like Denial is going to have to be competing with this bomb as it's ticking away. So time now the enemy, as well as the 3 players left alive for the stream team. Statutory Ape in a great position. There is Nath ready to shoot down Volcano, but it's none other than Statutory Ape who's got the back of his teammate Volcano, and Peck's going to come in to frag the guy on short, and the stream team going to pull together around, at least in the very end, but an 11-4 scoreline is certainly a really nice start for Denial, and they're going to be feeling very comfortable. I'm sure of it. Then look, what do you think it is right now for Denial? Do you think they're just out executing? Is it as simple as that?
Anger has 2 kills.
you're going to leave it there, right?
that doesn't help.
Does not help, no.
Yeah, again, it is a team effort, and you can see all the Denial plays in the double figures at the moment, ranging from 11 to 15 kills. So I think that's going to be one of the most important things at this point. Now, we are going to see the pistol round here in the second half, so anything can happen. We've got a 3-man stack from the CTs on the A bomb site. Going to rotate around to short, but all the Ts are in long. They won't be far away in order to save the bomb site, though, but if they have to try and defend it from the short to B area, they're not going to have really any cover from the numerous Ts who are pushing forward to the bomb site right now.
Oh, 2 quick frags found by Adren, and he does finally go down, but he's done some great work for his team. In comes the HE. Big chunk of damage done to Naf now as Anger tries to work his way in. And does actually catch a nice bullet onto Naf as he does go down to 14 points of health. Shazam going to work onto Statutory Ape and find himself a quick kill. This does become a 2-on-2. And a 1-on-2. And Shazam going to find himself the equalizing frag. The bomb taking away. Anger going to try his luck against Shazam as he goes for the drop. Awkward angles found, but he does get the kill. Picks up the kit. And precious time saved as he is now going to be able to execute the defuse. And we're going to see the stream team picking up the pistol round of the second half and thus giving themselves some hope to stay alive on Dust 2.
This could be the start of something beautiful here for CST, but they are still 6 rounds behind. They should be in good stead to take this one, as they will have the M4s versus potential pistol buy here from the terrorist side. So we're going to see all, 4 P250s and 1 just with the Glock. So just a very conservative eco here from T's. are going to get cut down like cheese in a grater, but they eventually get two frags, actually. They make it 3v3 here, and they've managed to pick up one M4. Not sure where the second one fell, but this is just beginning here for Denial on this second round.
And Naf is...
got both the M4s.
Yeah, working that PC50, going to go down. Can the damage control come in from the stream team? Or will these M4s be the death of them? No armor on those players, and that's really the big deal. Is that aim punch, once again, going to make life hard. Going to be finding quick frags. Got to find those heads. Just a bit of damage done to Statutory Ape. Nitro is going to fall back. 50 seconds, they can double back. They absolutely can double back. They can run all the way to B if they want with this amount of time. But they're just going to slowly edge their way onto it. I think if they wait just a good 10 seconds or so, they can instill enough doubt to remove some players from positions. And that's already starting to happen. Now they're going to go for it. They've waited a good amount of time. Statutory Ape getting quite low, but that bomb should go down now. Going to see Fugly get that down, as Nitro is going to be lending him aid. Here he goes. Finds a couple players below. So his teammate does get taken out by Statutory Ape. Finally, in return come in. Nitro unable to find the bullets to do that. And they do get the bomb down at the very least, but can't help but feel that they could have perhaps even gotten some more frags in there.
Indeed, but it wasn't to be, and TST find another round to add to the board. They survive with three players as well, which is definitely something. Could have been a lot worse for them, but they only have to have two people rebuy. They will have to have M4s thrown over from teammates, because they don't have enough to go for it themselves. That will leave Adren, for example, on zero. No money in the bank now, and averaging between, well, about 1,500 to 1,300 for the whole team.
See them make their way into Upper Dark, a pretty normal spread now from Denial. And so they are looking to take the early bits of map control that are going to allow them to make those decisions later on, whether to go for B or A, how to attack it, what tactics to use to accomplish their ends. And so far, actually, you know, we can just check the overview and see that it's a pretty defensive setup, which has pretty much voided middle entirely. The stream team want nothing to do with middle at the moment, which is smart considering that Shazam is playing that AWP, and this is something that they're aware of, as they do have Anger in place, who's got the crossfire with Statutory Ape, as we can see, on middle. And he is going to be able to back away to throw up the nades so Adrian can get the shots on if they do push short. And that's actually going to be the case with Shazam edging on. You can see that he's going to get assaulted there. He's got the AWP in his hand, but no armor. Got to be careful. Just one bullet to the head. And he is certainly a goner. Ooh, barely missing the shot there. Very close one. Kano going to put in the defense. Coming up to the window. Takes down two players as the mid pushes slowly silenced. Naf, though, with something to say. And he cannot be denied. Peck's coming in from the flank. Pushing straight out of the A longhouse. Finds the kill into Shazam. Do you have just two players left for Denial now? As they are looking to swing back momentum now straight away. They don't want to wait too much longer. They want TSC to build up some rounds first. But it is a very hard 2-on-4 for them. Naf is going to have to come out huge here. Nitro already getting the frag on the flank over towards Dark. So Naf is looking to see what he can accomplish. Going for the peaks. Time to step into shots. Going to connect much. Nitro going to have to do a lot here. Unable to pull the second frag onto Adren. Almost managed to do it though, considering how low Adren was with that spray. And the AWP is going to be found by Adren. So TST able to start stringing together more and more rounds as Denial look to be losing the grip of the map.
Indeed, they really are racking up the victories here. I'm not even sure if Denial have won a single round on this half yet. So they are finding themselves. Indeed, that's a big fat zero here for the second half. And three rounds in a row for TST. It's going to be Denial on the eco once again. That's a meaty nade and a second one to follow up as well, which leaves Shazam dead and Fugly on 40 HP. And TST, he will be playing the range game. We've got counter flashes coming in here, stopping the pushes from TST in mid. They're going to throw that smoke, which is going to smoke off CT spawn, and run in up the tunnels towards the B site. Another one bites the dust here. And yet another one, only two left, both in B tunnels. on the site, in fact. And it's going to be hyper aggression here from Volcano, not having any of it. He won't be hiding behind a box anytime soon.
So good money for both teams at this point in time. So don't know, can they stop TST now? Do you have the AWP on Fugly, but should pawn it off to Shazam. Indeed, it will find its way to Shazam. Ready for the situation in the middle here. But here comes the perhaps delayed peek from Adren. Or he's just going to wait on the angle. Just that could be his intention. Okay, he's going to jump across. Caught him just in time there. He's trying to go back across again. And it is all about positioning once more. They're in that stage of the game now where they got to say, okay, we've got dark, we've got short. Well, they don't have short just yet. They're slowly pushing their way up short. And then eventually they'll be like, all right, who is brave enough to take the peek in to see what's going on? And they are going to get smoked off there. So they can't really do much there. There's been moments when this has happened and they've moved down middle instead, but we'll have to see how they handle it now.
Indeed. Round is going to be slowed down by these nades. That is a great smoke on the short area. Absolutely no vision whatsoever for the T's, but it will dissipate and allow them to see once again. Dab's going to throw a smoke of his own, try and run some distraction. They are going to push at long at the same time, but are they going to PK on the left of the blue? Pex is going to get a frag on Fugly, but the Kraco's coming in here for both teams. That's going to leave it 3-3 here, but it'll give the advantage to the T's for the time being, as they do have a two-pronged assault on the bomb site. Anger doing huge work, though, leaving Daps on 9 HP, 9-26. Daps will find the frag, though, on the ape on short. Gives him a man advantage. The HP, again, isn't saying a lot, and there's a perfect example of why.
Oh, that jump was not well received. The Nile decide that this is a no-jumping area. No jumping zone. Anger just trying to find himself some information before he decides to go in. He will take down one player, and that's spray down. Little bit off to begin with, but he will finish off the job. As the Nile pick themselves back up around. They're 4 ahead now, as they rise to prominence once more. But Stream Team able to have quite enough bank to keep the buyers a coming. And this is going to keep things up in the air for the Nile as they are in a similar economic stead as their opponents. So this round is worth 2 for both teams. So we'll have to see who's going to start taking control here. If Denar win this, they're already on 14, essentially. So oh my god! Sickening frag coming in from Nitro, finding Anger as they make their way in. They do have Ugly leading the charge across the crossover, tagged down to 19. That smoke not really covering all the way. Spam finding players here, there, and everywhere as Naf is watching the back. And Adren is going to put one straight in his chest with that AWP, but I'm not sure if they fancy this retake. It's going to be very tough indeed. Here goes Adren, though. Spawn onto Graffiti. However, there are still players all over the place. They are outnumbered. Not necessarily outgunned, but certainly outnumbered as Adren tries to make his way with the ape out of this this danger zone, and finds the next shot as well. And whenever I say danger zone, I think of the song "Highway to the Danger Zone" from Top Gun. I don't want to sing that though; it's too advanced for me.
Please don't.
Highway. No, I won't do that. I won't subject everybody to that. Maybe
did
another
that
time.
That actually just happened.
It just I didn't go all the way though.
Holy potatoes.
The thing is, though, if I had completed that word, I would have felt compelled to sing the rest, and then we would all be doomed.
Denial, 3 rounds away from the first game of this best 3. Hopefully they make it there and I can get away from DDK for a few minutes, as his singing does somewhat scare me. We do have Shazam with the AWP for the T side and Adren with the AWP for the counter terrorist. Let's look at the positioning of both of these AWPers. In fact, we have Daps carrying the bomb towards B, while the AWPers are going to have a look around mid. You can see Shazam right there. And then in the meantime, Adrenaline is going to be also in mid. Trying to get tagged here. Misses the quick shot on the Pika. Just running past to get some information. Find out where the AWP is playing. See how they can exploit the site. Here comes the push.
Wow. Great work from the PT-50s. Found a lot of troubles now in the form of these pistols. The Nile struggling, slowly going to equalize things though, and again, the weapon advantage allowing them to do just that. to see if they're able to get the bomb down there, but that's their primary concern. Shazam going to discard Pex in dark, as now finally Anger will make his way through. It's a very fancy 5-7, but I've Fairy's about to lose it. Bomb goes down as Anger makes the peek. There is an AWP there, wedged between the crate and the rocks. He has not picked it up. It can be more visible, especially as it's an Asimov. And Anger is going to keep working with that 5-7 for now. Very interesting. He could just pick up the AWP and just run out of there, but he's going to pick up the AWP eventually by jumping out. I think he just didn't see it. I think he just didn't register that it was there.
Indeed. Two rounds away now. Odds now, and the money is pretty shabby indeed for TST here, but they should be able to eke out some semblance of a buy. Possible Mag 7 purchase for Adrenaline. Let's see what he chooses to go with here. Lots of nades here for the CC side. They must have a plan. They've got four rifles and a 5-7. Do have some teasing from the terrorists here. One's holding an angle, but that smoke will stop here. We've got a three-man push here on long, and the tease will smartly retreat for the time being, so it's going to preserve their guns. I'll take the duels just yet and abuse the unknown location of the bomb to their advantage here.
I think we just saw a bullet rain skin there. I think that's my favorite M4 skin, but I digress. We're going to see Dren just popping down. He got the spot, the information for his team, and the nade is going to go in, do a little bit of damage here and there. However, did we just get a freeze? I hope this is just a bit of a, yeah, just a bit of a lag on the game. And we're gonna find the head of Shazam as they make their way in denial. Having some problems here in the shape of Anger. He's gonna go down eventually though, thanks to Daps, as they do have Long under control. So there were two players. It would do very well to keep control of Long. They are getting challenged by Nitro. There it is, the interception with that 5-7 Adren. Excellent maneuver. With that 5-7, as there are three players left now, over towards the 8 bomb site. And in comes the retake. Slowly but surely, they are going to make their way up onto the site. So we do have Fugly, Daps, and Naf remaining. Bullets here, there, and everywhere. Naf, oh, he's in a bit of a dangerous position. Goes for the peak, a very key position as well. They do spot him down. And eventually the defuser does get taken out, and they have to try to go for the defuser. Is there time? I don't think there is. 2-1. There's no time, and it will go off. And that is the round there for denial, as they put themselves very close to a victory here. Match point, in fact. And there's 8 rounds for TST. They've got to get 8 in a row.
That was
7 in a row.
That was a disaster for TST. They were just too slow on that retake. They just couldn't breach in time, and the headshot count is going through the roof right now. 70 on the clock, and that's not going to be a wallbang there for Shazam. Looks close to me, but not close enough here. Volcano, again, doing well with the grenades here. Bomb is down into the B bomb site now, so this round is looking fantastic for TST. They suddenly raised their game. They are 5-2. They could even hunt for these players here. The flank is coming in from Pex in mid, and he's going to be going up into the tunnel, maybe, or just holding an angle, as obviously the awareness of the flank works both ways. So that flag going to be looking around, going to flashbang himself in and get the kill as well while his opponent looks away. So nice work there by Daps.
Well, this is certainly hopeless, isn't it? That bomb is just precariously positioned in front of those double crates at the exits from dark into the bomb site. And oh my god, Shazam finds the head of Volcano. That's going to be another one for the headshot counter indeed, as Shazam makes his way across, looking for the shot. Oh, he missed it! Somehow putting a bullet between the two players there. I think perhaps going through the legs of one, just over the helmet of another. As we do continue to be on match point. 9 rounds for TSC as they slowly climb their way back, but still, 6 more rounds for them, just 1 more for denial, and the best that TST can do right now is get the overtime. And see what Adrenaline's able to do. He's a scary, scary man, is Adrenaline, but Fugly's just going to go in. Heavy and hard with the Glock. Teammates following him. It's the Glock train. You can't stop it just yet, and it's going to be making its way all the way up long. Very bold moves here from denial. Haven't found anything else other than the first kill, though, and they might just settle back with the M4. Doesn't seem to be the case for now, as they regroup themselves. going to be a play on Daps. There he is, to make his way past the crossover. Coming in, and they are getting absolutely, wow, it's a bit of a slaughter, isn't it?
Indeed, but they are on the eco, and they've got two kills here, so this is going really well. They have cost the CTs a hell of a lot of money there, and Nitro will peek and get taken out by Adren, but the work was done there for Denial, just making TST stretch a little bit harder than they'd like to. You can see Anger there has got nothing in the bank after the buy at the beginning of this round. So, definitely worth that there for Denial. And they are going to be on the eco again, it seems. So they're going to make sure that they have lots of money in the bank as they go to the closing stages of this round. Going to try and avoid a situation where there's an overtime as much as possible.
Volcano takes down two before falling. It's actually just squaring it up, and the Daps will finally fall down to the HE. Oh my god, that's one for the Ragdoll Olympics. Naf now the last man standing, but again, you know, decent damage done by the pistols of Denial, but they are going to be sitting pretty on the following round with that all that cash that they are going to have generated. Just shoot through the doors already. And here's the flash. Oh, they're going to drag. Nothing comes his way. Dreng will pick him off, and TST only four rounds from the overtime. That's that doesn't sound nearly as bad as seven, which is what it was very like I think like 2 minutes ago.
Indeed, this is entirely doable here for the Stream team. Only four rounds behind. They do have the AWP as well. Both trying to get some shots through the door. See who can find who. Adren is going to be the one AWPing now. He's going to keep an eye on shorts. Oh, he sees these nades coming in. I think he would have missed that one. That flash coming in, allowing the deke. Not going to get a connection there.
Smart flash, very smart flash. Can see how much that saved him. I think had that flash not been there, I think Adren pretty much was going to snap that shot, pick up an early frag. So they want to express themselves on short, actually. That doesn't even make sense, but I don't care. Anger is there, ready to push down the stairs into a pick situation. He's able to get some support from his teammates. They were playing close on middle as well. TST actually looking to set up for a bit of aggression. If they can find the right moment, but the right moment is not quite appearing just yet. They find himself with a bit of trouble, but doesn't even get tagged really.
Denial running out of time here to push his sights. And running after grenades as well. They do have control of long, but they're not going to be able to push short anytime soon, as there are two CTs there. So it's going to be long almost all the way. Shazam missing a shot there, and they're going to try and get his bomb down with 20 seconds remaining. Anger's going to come and try and defend the site. He will take down Fuckley. Can he hold the site though?
See if he's going to be up to the task. It's Statutory 8 coming in with a nice headshot onto Naf. Go for the jump shot. The bomb is going to go down. No luck found with those jump shots. Century Ape is going to wrap itself around. Oh my god! Takes down Nitro on the move. As Daps is now the last man standing against two for Denial. Can't close. Volcano is going to take him down. And that's going to be 12 rounds of TST. They did get the plan on the bomb, so I think they will be able to buy up again. And indeed, they'll have a decent buy coming in. But once again, if they spend all their money now, which they will, that is another eco. Well, actually, they're going to have 3,400 for the max bonus, consecutive round loss bonus. So if they're pretty much on $0, they're gonna barely. Yeah, they're gonna have to continue buying every single round until they win. They just have to from this point.
Okay, we've got TST going for the quick push down long. Two people there to secure it. Then they'll go send one back towards the A bomb site. So it is gonna be Pex in pit. He is gonna have some action coming his way at the moment. Chooses to get a Molotov down. That is a greatly placed Molotov. It's going to make it very hard for the T's to push, but they are going to potentially boost onto the blue here. Flash is coming in from his teammates, so he's got two people to support now. So they're going to have the crossfire here from Anger. He's got lots of targets to look at. People boosted, people not boosted. Daps is going to take out Peck. So this is a 2v3 now. There's lots of drags coming in. Daps is going to be the last man standing, in fact, for his team. So if they lose this, then things are going to get interesting.
1-3, I mean, Adren's still alive with the AWP. I don't fancy Dap's chances. Pop flash and go. Not going to find anything on the peak. Going to smoke himself. But he has to, he basically has to go for it, try to get the damage or try to get the plant. He might as well. And if he can find a quick one-on-one, obviously that's going to be the start of things. But TSC are going to be aware of this, and they will try their best, their darndest, to try to eliminate that possibility. You can see that's going to happen here on the A site, both on the double, the angle, pretty much a double angle for them, as Daps will peek towards the site. Good opportunity found as he will cut off the head of Volcano with the AK. There's 13 seconds left. He's just going to go for it and try to get that damage in. Oh, he's actually going to try for this. Maybe if he immediately got the shot whilst running, maybe he'd barely have enough time, but there's still the other player coming in from short, so match point still, but 13 rounds for TSC. They're just two away from the overtime now.
Indeed, it looks like they're going to force it up, in fact. I was going to say, I mean, they're going for the late buys here, but I thought they were going to try and eco for this round and go all in the last round with nades, etc. But they're going to buy what they can, and the AK is luckily trying to win the match with just a CZ here. So this is a mixed buy here, a forced buy from Smile. They've got more presence in B tunnels, but the smoke will be down. That'll waste a lot of their time. It would be suicide for them to push that smoke. Let's see how it goes.
Let's go in. They make their way down for the middle play, just peeking their way in. And neither team yet to give anything. As we do have them all making their way slowly through onto middle, and they can't bust their way in. There's actually a crossfire set up here. They're going to challenge it though. Denial in a lot of trouble now, as, oh, Adren almost getting taken down through the smoke. They are getting so, so low, but the frag's not coming. Finally, Nitro with one. Daps with one. The bomb is going to get planted by Nitro now, as it's a hell of a task to accomplish to stop this map going towards Denial from TST. As they do have that bomb ticking away. Nitro going to be facing, going to back away. Definitely not a good idea at this point, as Shazam gets positioned at the top of the window. It's a nice position. Arat does have its wrist though, but we'll have to see if he's able to execute, and he won't! It's all going to be on Nitro, not enough time killed. Nitro's going to come out huge, does get two frags, but the bomb is really far ticked. There is time for the defuse, and it will be saved. And I'm curious why they were... I know that it can be, you know, effective to go out and, you know, try to surprise find the peaks onto the... you know, onto the outside of the site, but in that situation when already so much time is killed on the clock, if you just want to delay, then I'm not sure. Either way, it didn't work out for Denial, who am I to judge, as we do have a 15-14 situation. TSC so close to tying this game up, forcing that overtime. There's a player in dark. This anger does get shut down immediately by Shazam. Very well played there. Two players already softened up dramatically.
Adren on the 30 bomb right now, going to be trying to hold down mid with the AWP. They are at a one-man disadvantage here. We've got the smokes coming in towards the CT area, which does suggest a push through mid to B, but we've got the Denial team loitering in the tunnel area, the upper tunnel area. So we'll see if they choose to go for the two-pronged assault, or if this is all a complete fake, a massive lie, and they go through to the A site. Time will tell here, and the time is 55 seconds left for the terrorist team. Looks like it is going to be a B push after all.
Fugly straight up, great movement. They're onto the double stack box. In come the entries from Denial to the good. Pex and Adren making their way in, but from the long ranges, this isn't quite going to work. Smoke covering Adren's approach. Finally make his way through now, as they are not messing around. Both dropping into the site. Fugly gets caught in the back. No idea that they're there. Two quick frags, and there's no cover on this window. It is causing huge problems. Pex in a one-on-one against Shazam. As Shazam has his reticle trained on the corner. Pex jumps on top of the Xbox, and he's going to find the frag Denial. It went to the last round. It went to the last man. But they're able to finally close. But that was too close for comfort.
Indeed, we really have to commend TST. That was a fantastic comeback by them. And again, Adren, ex-iBuy power player, just putting in so much work there for his team, made the 30 bomb happen, and it just wasn't enough at the end there, but fantastic play by him. And great play by Denial to eke it out after having a lot of pressure for a long time from those CCs.
All right. Well, we do have Cash coming up next, and Season as a Defider. That's the word. The decider. There we go. So guys, stay tuned. We'll have cash coming up after the break between these two awesome teams here for the John Wick Invitational. Stay tuned.